There's no conflict of interest.
I'd like to ask you as a LEAP board member, what the LEAP's position, what the pending legislation that they're supporting on TIF is.
We can talk about that.
I'd like to hear it now.
It's not agendized right now, and it has nothing to do with this.
I think it does.
I disagree.
Well, okay, I'll call the question on this also.
I have one question. Should trustee Buckhorst have just brought, I know that it's really not, because you're not profiting from it or anything like that, but because she's on the LEAP board and they're asking us for money, should she not?
Oh, I'll recuse myself from the vote.
Okay, I just want to make sure.
Well, let me answer the question. I don't think you have to recuse.
Yeah, you might not have to.
Unless you are paid lobbyist for the LEAP, and you're getting paid specifically to obtain the vote of the village of Shorewood, then you should recuse.
It is an unpaid volunteer position.
Finders?
Which is zero.
Right.
I get paid zero.
I was being facetious.
I know.
Yeah, but there's no conflict.
Okay, thank you for that clarification, so you can vote if you choose.
Yay.
So we have called the question. Let's take a vote.
Second.
Any second?
Unless everyone wants to vote.
I think there's really no need to call the question. Is that correct, everyone?
You just want to vote?
Okay, let's vote. There's a motion on the table.
Go ahead.
Yeah, but I did call the question.
Do you want to withdraw that and let a vote?
Fine.
Motion on the table is to approve $1,200 contribution to the League of Wisconsin Municipalities efforts for dark store lobbying efforts.
And there was a second?
Yes.
Okay, all those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Nay.
Motion passes 6-1.
And it's understood that that means to close the loophole, right? The lobbying efforts are just open-ended.
It's for this dark store.
For Assemblyville.
Can I ask that the village manager return at our next meeting with a report on where that funding is going to come from, since it's unbudgeted and we were unable to identify a source of that funding?
And I would just request that if we are talking money at any time, that you go on the fiscal note of where it comes from. Okay. Okay, thank you. Next agenda item is the...
Back to A.
Back to A. Consider professional services agreement with City Water LLC for design, engineering, and construction inspection for water main relay projects. Do we want just a brief summary from Leanne?
A memo covers the recommendation to move forward with City Water in the amount of approximately $30,000. If there are any additional questions that Leanne can answer with respect to the proposal, she's here to be able to do so.
I have one question. I believe I can't find my notes, but so my concern was that the bids, again, are so far off from each other. They're like, I think it's this contract. There was about 6 bids. Is that correct? It was the long bids. Okay. And so I'm just wondering, coming forward, can we write something better into our RFPs? I can't tell you without a million questions of why are these so different. The swing is so large, and it's happening with a lot of contracts. And so maybe it's just the standard in construction, but I've never, when I've reviewed construction, seen it the swing be so big consistently. And so I'm just wondering if there's, Leanne, if you could respond to maybe the rationale for that, for the different DPW projects, and is there, and then from the village manager, the second part is there more specific things we can write into the RFP so that we have a better, we can better judge the consistency among bids? So I don't know if you want to start.
Sure. To answer the last question, we always attempt to write any type of RFP or specifications for projects as tightly as possible. For lots of reasons, not the least of which is to be able to judge apples and apples. And we will continue to explore that. At this point, I couldn't put my finger on anything that says, we should have written that a little tighter, we should have written that differently. Pretty confident that, you know, this is a pretty straightforward project. It is what it is. So the only explanation I really have for the swing in the different costs on the proposals relates to the different amount of hours of effort that the individual firms propose.
But they're so off. It's like design is like 10 hours and then 97. Like how there's got to be a better way, because, and even for inspection services, I know we always adjust those, or we've been adjusting those, and is it, we came to some conclusion that we're more specific, you know, like saying, this is how much we think.
Mm-hmm.
I get the point of leaving it open-ended, but if there is, I mean, it's really hard for me to make any, I don't know why I'm reading over these, because there's no, I'm just going to, you know,
mm-hmm.
there's no explanation for me of...
That's a little bit the nature of how engineering, it's the firm's approach, and what mm-hmm. they believe, how they want to cover their selves. And I would be very uncomfortable giving them a target number of hours for design.
For construction or...
Well,
right?
I mean, we're pretty comfortable with target hours for inspection because generally speaking, we can assume a project length and then you assume a 50-hour inspection week. So, I mean, that's pretty easy one to give them a bread box or a ballpark. But you
maybe
know.
It's a timeline, like an end time. Like this is the time. I'm just thinking.
We did lay that out for them.
Well, I can't use that many hours because it's this. I don't know. But could you just look at that as an administration?
I would make a motion to approve a professional service agreement with City Water LLC for 2019-2021 water main relay project in the amount of $30,940.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. The next item on our consideration is the Wilson Drive Project Monthly Financial Report.
On the inspection, I mean, the project is almost 40% complete, but inspection only 15.72. Is that just that they haven't billed, or is...
Correct. I would expect that we'll receive an invoice from them this week.
Any other questions? I had one, but I can't find it, so I'll follow up. This isn't for approval, correct? Okay, so no further discussion, we will move on. The next item for consideration is communication plan for community outreach on snow dumping alternatives. Who wants to lead that conversation?
A little bit about just introduce the fact that we're not discussing the snow dumping alternatives tonight, but we wanted to first establish what our communication process would be for Calculate Item.
Mm-hmm.
So there has been a communication plan put within your packet tonight. There are some sections that require the board to weigh in to see if these are options or alternatives you'd like to choose. And then we will proceed so that we can have this dialogue with the public and then we can adequately inform people about what our steps are.
Tyler, do you have anything you'd like to add?
Primarily the part that I think I would appreciate feedback is we have kind of an optional ad hoc committee. I just want you to know that at this point that's an option. We don't necessarily need to do it, but I just want you to know it's an option if you want staff to do it, that we have the time to, you know, have a few meetings to do that. I think there's some pros and cons to each that you can weigh yourselves, but I just wanted you to know that that's certainly an option. And then in addition, is this something that you would feel you need a cow just to have an informational session on what's been done, and then two meetings later have the board take action, or is this something that you feel that you can do in one day at a board meeting? So those are some other things that I think we would appreciate some direction on.
Can I ask a question? Clarifying question. So the communication plan is based on the alternatives that are before us. So I'm a little concerned, and I'm asking if we can do this. So if you took off the table tonight dumping snow on Wilson and Menlo, okay, if the board's will was not to do either of those, your communication plan is totally different. So I am concerned that we're not, can we discuss that alternative? Because I, so for instance, I'm just gonna, as an example, if the board decided there's not enough for Bum Wilson and we don't want to get into communication ad hoc group of these people are gonna say they don't want it, these people are gonna say they don't want it, but if both of, if you took it off the table that neither are an option, then you don't need to go through that ad hoc committee. But if the board's will was to keep one of those options on the table, then that would change my mind on the communication plan. Because I don't think it would, in my personal opinion, I wouldn't be fair to say, we've taken Menlo off, but you know, now the Wilson people have no say. So either or, I'm just saying if there was the will of the board to look for a different alternative or at least to know where it is, the other options, that would change my vote on the communication plan. So I don't know the answer to that, but I do know I'm in favor of not pitting one side of the village against the other, and I don't think that would be productive at this point in time for our village. So my recommendation is to take those two off the table and look at the rest of the alternatives moving forward, and then we can structure a communication plan. But are we allowed to just take input?
Yeah.
I'm asking.
Right. I don't see anything.
Yeah,
and that directly impacts the communication plan. So.
It does directly impact it. So if there is a desire of the board to eliminate those options and the options were included, and it does fundamentally change some of these options that we've listed. So it depends on the will of the board.
Trustee McKay.
If that is the will of the board to discuss tonight, I would ask to defer it because I was not prepared to discuss that. And especially at 10 o'clock at night. There's no way I can
And given it's not on the agenda.
Well, it is because
communication.
Yeah, it would impact the plan because we wouldn't be proposing some of these options if that was the desire. So I can see how it is related.
Can I just speak on the deferral?
Sure.
Because I understand it's late. Mm-hmm. If we defer, though, the next meeting isn't until September. And there's a few issues with that. If we end up deferring, we're probably not going to make a decision until October. At the earliest, which if you decide as a board to just have the businesses take the lead with it, which is option one of the options, we want to make sure to give the businesses enough notification about that change, so that becomes problematic. In addition, one of the options is potentially working with someone off-site like the city of Milwaukee and dumping the snow that. Mm-hmm. If that's a direction that you take as a board, that might have a budgetary impact. Which if you're waiting until October, even into November, that's really late in the budget process. So, I mean, it's up to you as a board if you want to defer. I'm just letting you know that there will be implications, and it really challenges the process if you were to defer the item.
But I'm very frustrated because that conversation should have happened first. I know, and we can, you're saying we can have it tonight. Because I really feel, like he's saying about the business owners, if there's not the will of the board to leave the snow where it is, then there's no need for that mailing. So if I'm going to struggle without that conversation for at least having the dialogue in order to adopt a communication plan. So I don't want to waste money if the will of the board is not there. So I don't know how to proceed without at least discussing that. I'm okay with deferring it, but again, I do understand what Tyler's saying, and he's hoping that we discuss it. That's what he's saying. So
I think they're all the options. I mean, I'm not thrilled about continuing on dumping on Wilson and adding Menlo, but they are, I mean, we're going to have snow here shortly. We're going to have to work through it. And actually, it forces the community to look at the options and understand the cost differentials, that there's costs, there's environmental costs for shifting and for melting it. It's the reality. We've got, and if the bid, we're going to force the bid members to shovel their own snow. There's, you know, we're presenting all the options, and the board wants input on what option to pursue, and especially the business owners, they can hear from them.
So, can I make a suggestion? Are we, is anyone not in favor of the ad hoc committees? Because, and again, I'll just state the concern is, if we have the ad hoc committees to talk about Menlo and Wilson Drive, I don't know how much we're going to get out of those.
Trustee Mentor. When this was brought up at Conservation Committee, and several Menlo neighbors showed up, and, you know, my feeling, and their position was, yeah, we don't want it, it's toxic, it's, we, our kids are on that median, our pets, and, you know, we don't want it in our neighborhood, and I think the chair of the Conservation Committee made a pretty good argument, but there are kids and pets and people on Wilson, and we're building a presumably attractive, usable green area over there, so there's, you know, any, and I'm usually one for, you know, public input, having public process, and, you know, that's been a, you know, this is going to be the first time that I'm saying I'm not sure public process on this particular issue is going to be useful, because I think we know that everybody is going to say, I don't want it, I don't want it. And the conclusion of that meeting was, it should not be Menlo versus Wilson. It's right. Not. It is more, first there's a decision about the snow and business district. We're the only municipality that takes care of that issue for the businesses. We don't take care of it for the residents, but we do for the businesses, right?